In this illustration, we are going to discuss about flow velocity in viscous fluid. Here, we are given that in the arrangement shown in figure, a viscous fluid whose density is rho flows along a tube out of a void tank A. This is the tank A. Find the velocity of this liquid flow if these H1, H2, H3 are given as 10, 20 and 35 centimeters, all the distances L are equal. Now, in this situation, we can see if the flow velocity coming out is V, then obviously flow velocity throughout the tube must be V because the cross-sectional area is constant. So, if we consider points A, B and C, then we can use Poiseuille's equation between points A and B. We can write, for points between A and B, the cross-sectional area S multiplied by flow velocity, which is the rate of flow of fluid, that is equal to pi r to power 4 by 8 eta L multiplied by the pressure difference, which is here we can see the difference of pressure between these two points A and B is H1 rho g. And if we talk about between points B and C, then also you can see here SV should be equals to pi r to power 4 by 8 eta L. Pressure difference between two points is H2 minus H1 multiplied by rho g. And here, as the two left-hand side terms in equation 1 and 2 are same, that means right-hand side must also be same. And here you can see as H1 is 10, and you can see the value of H2 minus H1 is also 10. So this is in accordance with the fluid flow, which is homogeneous. So both of these equations are coming out to be correct for SV. And if we talk about this point D, then we can write between points C and D. Here, if we consider up to this level, say this height is H3 prime, which is not specified in the problem because this is the level which is being maintained. So we can directly write over here between points C and D. SV we can write it as pi r to power 4 by 8 eta L, and this should be equals to H3 prime minus H2 multiplied by rho g. And on calculation, as this should be equals to 10 centimeter, we can see H3 prime is equals to 30 centimeter because H2 is given as 20 centimeter. Now here we can see this is an extra distance of 5 centimeter which is there, and providing the velocity head or here pressure is P atmospheric. So this is the extra pressure head which is producing or which is causing the fluid to flow, because the pressure difference across C and D, B and C and A and D must be maintained same for it to flow at constant velocity. So H3 prime is the pressure head which is maintaining the flow velocity, and this extra distance which is 5 cm as H3 is given as 35 cm is causing the velocity to generate in the fluid. So we can say the extra pressure head which is causing fluid to flow is due to H3 minus H3 prime column, which is equals to 5 centimeter. This implies the flow velocity will get V is equals to root 2 g H3 minus H3 prime. How we are calculating this, you can apply Bernoulli's theorem. If the system is not there and there is a small hole created over here, then the flow velocity which is produced by this velocity head will be simply by Torricelli's theorem we are getting. Thus we can write by Torricelli's theorem, neglecting viscosity in wide container. Here, within this container, we can neglect the velocity as the container is very wide, so flow velocity here is very low. So, the velocity with which liquid will come out from this point is root of 2gh3 minus h3 prime. On calculation, we can get it root of 2 multiplied by g, we can take here as 10, and h3 minus h3 prime here is 0.1, so this coming out to be this 0.05, so this coming out to be 1 meter per second. That is the result of this problem.